Hello dear students, welcome to Bosco Campus Vision YouTube channel of Kottayam Don Bosco College. I am Rania, faculty member of PG Department of English. Today I am here with the paper European Fiction, which is the elective paper for MA Semester 3 students under Kerala University. In last classes, we are discussing the historical as well as literary background of European literature. So we had already covered Dark Ages, Ancient Classical Period, Middle Ages and also Renaissance Period. In this class, we are going to discuss more about the Enlightenment Period. Okay, so the Enlightenment Period hails from the last half of 17th century to the end of 18th century. Enlightenment Period is also known as the Age of Reason, which was also known as Neoclassical Age. Why Neoclassical Age? The term Neoclassical Age, the term may be familiar to you because you had already completed the historical background of British literature. Why Neoclassical Age? Yes, we can see some of the elements of Classical Age in the literature of the Enlightenment period. That is why the Enlightenment period is also known as Neoclassical Age. At that time in Europe, France was the superpower. England had also their literary output. During this time, as I mentioned, this is the Age of Reason. So, during this time, a series of disputes, philosophical as well as literary disputes arise, and which resulted a series of a big number of genius, literary genius and also philosophical thinkers. These thinkers, they started thinking on the basis of reason. So sometimes they are called rationalists or empiricists. René Descartes, very famous, I think therefore I am. And also John Locke's philosophy, tabula rasa, that means blank slate. We had already learned that philosophy, blank slate philosophy in the previous semester. So all these arise during this time. There are two kind of believers in Europe during the time. One is deist and the other one is optimist. Deist believes that the existence of God, it is on the rational ground. That means on the basis of reason, they believe there is existence of God. Whereas this optimist believe the existence of world is best possible with all its defects. Okay, so this is the major historical background of European literature during the Enlightenment period. Now let's check some of the literary features of Enlightenment period. In the Neoclassical age or the Enlightenment period, France and England were the only nations having much literary output. Neoclassicism tried to revive all the virtues of classical works of Greek and Rome. People of Europe, especially writers and thinkers of Europe, started following Horace and Virgil. Horace and Virgil, as I mentioned in one of our previous classes, the great classical masters. So the writers of Europe started following the rigid classical rules. By applying these rules in literature, they react against the extravagant fires of Renaissance period. So which was the period immediately before the Enlightenment period? It is Renaissance period. So the writers reacted against the extravagant fires of Renaissance period. And when we analyze the Neoclassicism, it poses certain features. Reason, logic, order, law, rules, etc. are beginning to execute in literature. And when we analyze the Neoclassical literature, we can see that unity was one of the chief specialty of literary output. The writers gave value to the correctness, proportion, harmony, etc. They distrust in innovation. So they emphasize on general and typical, not on individual and specific. They believe in art rather than nature. Epic and drama were the two major literary output during the time of Neoclassical age. So when we analyze the British literature, it is in the Neoclassical age we are going through several type of mock epics and also satirical works. So these are the major literary features of Neoclassical age. Now let's check who are the major literary figures during this period in European literature?
Now let's check major literary output and writers of European literature during the Enlightenment period. First one is Pierre Corneille. He was a French tragedian. His tragedies are often psychological studies of heroic men and women. He was famous for his tragedies Medea, The Liar and The Cid. Another important figure is Jean Racine. He was a playwright, but later he became a royal historiographer. His major tragedies are Andromache and Phaedra. Another figure is Molière. Molière was actually the pen name of Jean-Baptiste Poquelin. He was also a playwright, but he was a comedian. He was considered as the father of modern French comedy. His comedies are Tartuffe or the Imposture, The Misanthrope, The Would-Be Gentleman. Another important figure during the time of Enlightenment period is Desproges. He was also a man of letters. He was famous for his poem Art of Poetry, in which he formulated neoclassical principle of literature. Another prolific writer of comedies was Jean Lafontaine. He was also famous for his lyrics, elegies, ballads, etc. He is remembered primarily for his selected fables, which were set in verse form. It was not in prosaic form, but it was set in verse form. Another important Enlightenment thinker from France was Voltaire. Voltaire is actually the pen name of Francois Meres Arouet. Candide or Optimism was his most read philosophical work. So these are the prominent writers of France during the time of Enlightenment period. The writers from England also enriched European literature with their literary output. John Dryden was the literary dictator of neoclassical age. He wrote satirical and didactic poems. Absalom and Achitophel and Macfleckno are his famous works. Famous writers of comedy of manners were William Congreve and Richard Bentley Sheridan. Congreve's The Way of the World and Sheridan's The School for Scandal are famous. Another important writer from England was Samuel Pepys. He was a famous diarist of neoclassical age. Alexander Pope also was the epitome of English neoclassicism. His smoke epic, The Rape of the Lock, and critical work, An Essay on Criticism, are famous. Jonathan Swift was an outstanding prose satirist. His Tale of a Tub, The Battle of the Books, Journal to Stella, Gulliver's Travels, etc. are famous literary output. Joseph Addison and Richard Steele were the contributors of periodical The Tatler and The Spectator. Periodical essay writers were these two. Another important figure was Dr. Samuel Johnson. He was also a periodical essay writer and he was a contributor of London-based The Gentleman's Magazine. He was famous for the Dictionary of English Language and a pessimistic poem, The Vanity of Human Wishes. Daniel Defoe and Henry Fielding are the novelists of England. Defoe is celebrated for his frank and dramatic realism in fiction. For example, Defoe's Robinson Crusoe is very famous. Henry Fielding was excelled with the publication of the novel Tom Jones. These were the prominent writers of European literature from England during the time of Enlightenment period. So, many neoclassical literary figures were moralist and realist during this time. We can say that the Enlightenment period was a period of satire.
In short, we can say that like all other literary periods, the Enlightenment period also gifted a series of well-acclaimed writers to European literature. I'm concluding today's class. See you with another topic in the next class. I remind you one thing, do the homework and send me. Thank you.